Welcome to the first lecture on Introduction to Proc. Let's start by defining what a proof assistant is. A proof assistant is a program that takes proofs written in a specific language and checks whether it is correct. Okay. So if it is correct, it says the proof is accepted, otherwise it says it is rejected. Okay. The important point here is that the software doesn't try to prove your theorem, but what it does is it tries to check the correctness of your theorem. Okay. So you can use this to be sure that your proof is correct. The underlying idea behind a proof assistant like Coq is the following. Okay. We think of a programming language which has types, like for example the type of natural numbers, strings, etc., and values like 2, hello, or let's say 3 plus 5, okay, or 4 plus some x, okay, things like that, where x is a variable. And the type checking problem in a programming language is whether given an expression and a type, you check whether e is of that type t. Okay. This is a problem that when you implement programming languages you encounter. Okay. So there is a surprising connection between proof checking on one side and type checking in a sufficiently powerful type system. Okay. And the connection is as follows. Mathematical statements can be recast as types in your language, and a proof of A can be given by producing a value of PF of type A, where A now means the type associated with the mathematical statement A. Okay. We will see the details of this in the course, but the main idea to take away is that if you have a programming language with a sufficiently advanced type system, the type checking problem can double up as a proof checking mechanism, and hence the programming language implementation or compiler or interpreter can act like a proof assistant. This deep connection between type checking in a programming language and checking proofs in mathematics is very interesting and is very important. Okay. From the programming language side, what we now have is a powerful programming language where you can simultaneously write programs that can be run via a process called extraction. So the extraction is a process where you can extract an executable program out of the proof that you have written. And you can also prove the correctness of the program that you have just written. Okay. So it doubles up both as a implementation language for the exciting software that you want to write, compiler or whatever. It also acts as a way to prove the correctness of the software that you want to write. Okay. So such writing such programs are called certified programs. Certified in the sense that programs comes with proof of correctness. On the mathematical side, what you have is a style of proving theorems which is unlike what we have in mathematics. Proofs are no more lifeless facts, but are values that can be manipulated using a programming language. Okay, this has consequences to the way we prove things. Hopefully, the set of lectures will convince you of the power of this style of proving things. We end this lecture by giving you an indication of how to go about working with Coq. Okay? It is very important that we work in the interactive setting to get the maximum out of a proof assistant like Coq. It doesn't work by we writing the entire proof and then turning it over to Coq, although that is how it appeared to from the initial picture. We build the proof rather in an interactive way by interacting with the proof assistant. Okay, so it is required that you have Coq, you have Emacs, and Emacs is an editor which I am sure many of you are already familiar with. But the role played by Emacs is very important in this case, unlike in the case of any other programming languages. It also gives you a platform through which you can interact with Gog. And this interaction, is, as I said, is very important. Okay. And there is an Emacs mode, particularly for Gog, called Proof General. Of course, it can work with other proof assistants as well. But we need this mode to be installed as well. There are a couple of optional things that you might need. You can use a mode called the Company Cog mode in Emacs, which kind of gives you some additional bells and whistles on top of Proof General. Like, for example, pretty Unicode notation, command completion, etc. Okay, this is optional. In fact, I would recommend that you don't install this in the beginning. Okay, you may install it later on when you are comfortable with the system. And of course, you might want LaTeX and tech packages so that you can compile the documentation and code that you have written. Okay, so this is what you need. And I should emphasize again that it is through interaction that we get to the final proof. So it is very important that we have hands-on experience with these systems. If you are using one of the standard Linux distributions, you can just install it as using the package manager. Okay, so Gog, Emacs, and Proof General mode is available on Debian and Ubuntu, for example, as packages. So you all, it means is that you just install it over the terminal. Okay, yeah. So that's it. That's for the that's the first lecture. We will come back with more details in the next lecture onwards.